Hi everyone, it's James here with Studiospares. I am a very lucky boy right now as I've got my hands on the new, the brand new SSL Solid State Logic UF8 8 Fader DAW Control Surface. Let's not waste any time, let's dive in and find out what the UF8 is all about. Getting the UF8 to talk to your DAW is really very simple, and I think it's something that SSL have spent a lot of time and energy on, as some control surfaces, naming no names, can be at best a little tricky to get going. Once you have it out of the box, you can attach the optional legs in a number of different orientations, so you get the optimal angle of attack. These legs have a really nice foot feature, so you can get the unit absolutely stable, even on an uneven surface. The legs do, however, attach with an Allen key screw rather than a Phillips or flathead. Really, SSL? Once you've attached the legs, it's time to get connected. UF8 uses the USB connection of your PC or Mac, and today I'm using it with my Windows 10 PC. SSL provide a USB-C to USB-C cable, as well as a USB-C to USB-A cable, so there's nothing stopping you from getting going. Connect from the USB-C port on the back of the UF8 to your computer using the appropriate cable. The USB-A port on the UF8 is for daisy chaining units together. We can connect up to 4 UF8s together to give us a 32 fader surface. Once the USB is connected, hook up the power supply and the unit will come to life in a flurry of faders and coloured lights. Lovely. UF8 is basically a Huey or Mackie control surface, and while this is true, you do need to also download and install the SSL 360 control software. This is available from the SSL website. 360 needs to be running whenever you use your UF8. 360 really does open up the true power of the UF8, but we'll come to this in a minute. Now, I don't have the scope in this video to cover full setup instructions for each of the 5 thus far supported DAWs. Those being Pro Tools, Logic Pro, Cubase, Ableton Live, and Studio One. But SSL have done a full setup video guide for each, so you're going to want to check this out when it comes to getting your UF8 configured with your DAW. However, one little tidbit I did pick up, UF8 can talk to up to 3 DAWs at the same time. Getting your first DAW set up is very easy. You can find out the MIDI ports you need to assign in the 360 software. When you want to assign your second or third DAW, click on the Port button in the Layer 2 or Layer 3 tab and assign the ports listed, not just the next one sequentially. This is all to do with using multiple UF8s, and there is, of course, full instruction and explanation in the user guide. But who reads the manuals, right? The SSL UF8 is laid out in a very logical and straightforward way. At its heart, we have 8 100mm touch-sensitive motorised faders, 8 V or virtual pots, and 8 beautiful little backlit screens. Now, one of the issues I had with the original Huey controllers was the lower than I might like fader resolution. It was usable, but being a MIDI controller, it only had 128 steps to any of the controls. Well, SSL have worked their magic. Hold tight, it's going to get technical for a moment, but stick with it. By taking advantage of the fact that modern DAWs send and receive 2 MIDI values per fader position, the most significant bit, MSB, and the least significant bit, LSB, they've managed to get 10-bit fader resolution, or 1,024 steps, enough for even the most demanding mix engineers. Okay, back to the tour. Each channel has a solo, cut or mute, and selection button, and these can be modified with the selection mode keys to the right. We start off in normal mode, and if I want to select more, I can just hold down the first selection and hit more of the selection buttons. This also works for cut and solo. If we hit rec or record, the selection keys now become record arm buttons. And if we hit auto, we can open up the automation mode selection, which is in the bottom left of UF8. We can then select the channel or channels and choose the automation type we want to use. Back in the selection modes, you'll see a second row of text. If I hold down the norm button, I can clear selections. The record button becomes the all function, and the auto button becomes zero. So if I want to, I can set selected faders back to zero at the touch of a button. Or by holding zero and all, I can set all faders back to zero. Above the faders are the V-pots. These are continuous encoders that by default are set to your pan pots. And if you want to control the right-hand pan, just hit the pan key to the right of the V-pots. By hitting the Fine button, you put the pans into Fine mode for accurate placement in the stereo image. In Fine mode, you also get a numeric value of the pan position. Below the Selection mode, we have the Main Channel Encoder and Navigation section. By default, this is how we scroll around the channels in the session one at a time. If you want to, you can also jump by banks of 8 using the bank keys. In Nav mode, I can move the playhead. In Nudge mode, I can move a selected clip by the nudge value. And in Focus mode, I can quickly take control of parameters inside plugins. Just hover the mouse over the control and make the adjustment. Below this, we have the cursor and mode keys. These allow me to move around the session, or with the mode key enabled, I can zoom horizontally or vertically, depending on how your DAW is configured. In the top right, we have the soft keys. Now, UF8 has 43 configurable keys, and using SSL 360, pretty much any of these can be reassigned. However, the user keys are the keys specifically designed for this purpose. In Pro Tools, we have 4 pre-configured layers and a 5th empty layer for your own custom assignments, which are all handled by the 360 software. In the top left of UF8, we have the layer and quick keys. UF8 can control up to 3 DAWs at the same time. In this example, I have Pro Tools and Studio One open, and I can toggle between controlling Pro Tools and Studio One using the layer keys. The quick keys allow me to change the window I'm viewing. In Pro Tools, I have quick key 1 assigned to toggle between mix and edit windows, key 2 to open and close the transport, and 3 to open and close memory locations, but these are all entirely user configurable. Below this, we have the send selection, and as you might expect, I can take control of the sends, A through E in Pro Tools, this is a Huey limitation, just by clicking on sends 1 through 5. The send level appears in the screen for each channel, and if I wish, I can flip this onto the faders using the flip key. A shorthand version of the name of each send also appears, so you can keep track of what it is you're adjusting. Next down, we find the plugin and channel buttons. Hitting Channel turns the UF8 purple and into channel mode, where we have access to the 5 sends and the pan control via the VPOTs. I can change the status of the sends using the button above the screen, flipping between pre and post fader. The plugin button turns the UF8 cyan blue and allows me to take control of my plugins. If I select a channel with some plugins instantiated, I can click on numbers 1 through 5 and close and open the plugins, and take control of the parameters using the VPOTs, and access more parameters using the page keys or VPOT 8 to scroll through the pages. I'm the first to admit that traditionally, I'm not a massive fan of control surfaces. I've owned most of them and found the learning curve just too steep, and well, I just never really got on with them. However, UF8 is different. I've only had it for a couple of days now, and I'm already flying around it with, well, quite a lot of confidence, to be honest. Yes, I know I have a large format analog console, and UF8 might seem like overkill, but actually, they're a perfect partner. I can control my DAW, in this case Pro Tools, and my plugins from UF8, and I still have all that lovely analog sound. UF8 is built like a tank. It's aluminium with a beautiful anodized top plate. The pots feel really good and solid. The buttons have a nice confident feel, and the faders are fast and responsive, and not at all noisy when responding to automation data. In short, I love this thing. Because it runs under Huey or Mackie control in the case of Studio One, you do have to be creative with your track labelling, as you're only going to get 4 characters showing track names in the screens. But hey, 99% of the time, the automatic truncation is working just fine. Because UF8 is not enabled for Yukon, there are no options for VCA, spill, or any super advanced features that you might have access to in Pro Tools via an S1, an Avid S4, or S6. But you do have to remember that UF8 is priced under £1,000, and it's fully self-contained. There's no need to buy a tablet or iPad to get the full functionality. If you require more than 8 faders, you can hook 2, 3 or 4 UF8s together to give you up to 32 faders. However, the VPOTs can be assigned differently across multiple UF8s in your rig, so you could have soft key bank 1 on your first UF8 and bank 2 on the second, giving you over 80 fully customizable assignable buttons. And I've not even started on the ability to create macro shortcuts, making a single button push do multiple tasks. Sorry, Studiospares, this UF8 is staying right here. That's how much I'm enjoying this thing and how impressed I am with it. SSL, you've made a control surface user out of me. So I really hope you enjoyed this video and this look at the new SSL UF8 control surface. For more info on the UF8 and our full range of SSL products, check the website www.studiospares.com. My name's James Ivey, and I'll see you again very soon.